Hello, my name is John Maiorana, and I am the Technical Support Manager for Arkema's Forane Refrigerants. Arkema is a global chemical company that develops and manufactures various materials used in numerous industries around the world. I work in the fluorochemical division where we make Forane refrigerants. Today, we're going to show you how to retrofit an R-22 system with Forane 427A. In this case, it's a 15-ton, three-stage AC package unit. Before I start, I'd like to explain a few things about the different refrigerants that Arkema makes. For several years, the industry used chlorinated refrigerants. Many of you might remember R-12, R-502, and certainly you're aware of R-22. Chlorinating a refrigerant provides some ideal characteristics. One, good thermodynamics. Two, non-flammable, non-toxic. And three, good oil characteristics, basically miscible with many different oils. The chlorine aspect, though, depletes ozone in the atmosphere. Therefore, in the 1990s, we developed hydrofluorocarbons, or HFCs. Many commercially available refrigerants today are blended from four HFC gases: R-32, R-125, R-134A, and R-143A. Compared to R-22, each one of these gases has a disadvantage. Two of them are mildly flammable, R-32 and R-143A. Three of them are higher pressure, with two of them much higher pressure, and that would be R-32 and R-125. One of them is lower pressure, R-134A. However, that does have much lower capacity as well. Therefore, we blend these refrigerants together to create a comparable refrigerant to 22. Hence, blended refrigerants. I have a few HFC blended refrigerants here, and I'd like to explain the differences between them. 407C and 427A are made from the same three refrigerants: R-32, R-125, and R-134A. However, 427A has an addition of 10% 143A. This allows 427A to be more tolerable of mineral oil than 407C, hence we can use it in many systems without changing the oil. 407A is made from the same components as 407C, but it's in different ratios. And the way it's formulated, it works better in lower temperature, low temp applications, hence freezers. All three of these refrigerants will provide comparable performance to R-22 respective to the application. In this case, 427A and 407C will provide very comparable performance to R-22 in air conditioning and refrigeration. However, again, 427A can be used with mineral oil, whereas 407C, you must use POE. Before we get started with the retrofit, our first step, and always, is safety. These instructions are meant to be utilized by qualified HFC technicians only. As technicians, we all know that proper eyewear, proper footwear, and proper clothing is mandatory whenever we work on any HVACR system. So let's get started. First things first is we want to record how the system is running on R-22. Suction and discharge pressure and temperature, superheat, subcooling, and current draw. I also like to do the air temp drop across the coil to see how the system's performing. If the system is not running, you're going to need to target a superheat subcooling you're trying to attain. Once we have those parameters, we want to shut down the system and recover the R-22. Record the amount of R-22 you're recovering, or in this case, the OEM charge side is 11 pounds per stage. Once we recover the R-22, we want to determine if we need to either add or change over to POE. 427A is completely compatible with mineral alkyl benzene. However, unlike 22, it's not completely miscible. As I explained earlier, it's formulated to be tolerable mineral oil, so in cases like this, we can use the existing oil. It is also recommended to check the oil quality for acidity and debris, etc. because if you have poor oil quality, you're going to run into future problems. Next, I want to install a filter dryer. It's always good practice to install a new filter dryer whenever you open any system. And I'm also going to replace the Schrader core valves. Now that we've installed our filter dryer and replaced the Schrader core, it's time to pull a deep vacuum. We recommend pulling vacuums of 500 microns or more. We've leak checked the system, our vacuum held. Now we're ready to charge Forane 427A into the system. We recommend charging 90% of the original R-22 charge. Since we're working with a blended refrigerant, you must charge in a liquid state. I'm done charging 90% of the R-22 charge into the system. I'm going to start up the system now. I'm going to let it run for about 20 minutes. Then I'm going to add additional refrigerant to attain my superheat and subcooling. Be careful when you're charging a liquid refrigerant into a running compressor. You don't want to slug the compressor. In this case, I'm using a flash valve to prevent that. Okay, that concludes our retrofit today of Forane 427A. I encourage you to visit our website, forane.com. There you'll find a link to download our PT app to your phone. You'll also find the retrofit guideline, and there'll be information there for our tech support department. Feel free to call our department if you have any questions regarding refrigerants.